Okay, it's the blue collar preacher today. I'm going to show you how I turn these. These used to be French doors, and they're from an older house than this old house. This house is pretty old too, but we're relocated to Cheyenne, Wyoming now from Utah. Have to keep working, but I'm going to show you how I converted these barn doors into, these French doors into barn doors. French doors are, the older ones were like 80 inches tall, which is about 6'8", that's normal size, I guess. And then barn doors are taller because your rough opening here is usually 83 inches. That's an in, 6 foot, 11 inches. So when you sheetrock it, corner beat it and everything, the barn door has to sit higher because of the, to fill in the gaps. So we added some wood to it, filled in the old hinge holes on the side here. Used to have three hinges on each one. The homeowner here, she just wanted to utilize the old hardware, but I made it solid. We filled in the striker hole and the hole here. I got it latched right now, and I'm going to take you to the other side and show you how I latched it. But we're going to show you briefly on how I extended them up and filled in these holes and stuff to make them nice barn doors now. These doors are 80 inches and they need to be at 83 at least. We're going about 83 and a quarter, 83 and an eighth. Something just to make them work for barn doors. They're just old doors out of an old house that she liked, and they look good, and we're going to make them look good again. Okay, getting ready to mill this piece of 4x4 down to add to the bottom of our barn doors or top. Whichever the homeowner decides, we'll find out here in a sec. I got to cut them down to 5/4. That's how thick the doors are, so getting ready to do that. Here's my new table saw I bought. It's a Skill worm drive. It's what I use to cut that wood for the door. It's going to come in a lot handier than that old Pro Tech or whatever I bought from Sutherland's about 20 years ago. I picked this up at Home Depot for about $600 and did the job really well. It's going to serve me well. Okay, homeowner decided to put this on the top. So we're going to put this on the top. Ran this through the table saw. 5/4 by 3 inches. Or 1 1/4. So we're going to glue that on there. First, I got to countersink holes down for 3-inch screws. 4 of them all the way across. Using a 3/8 spade bit. Reason being is so my shaft will fit in there for the impact. Like using Torx head screws, because you can really bite down on them things. I'm gonna have to put the camera down, but start at one end and adjust and work your way to one end. Don't put both ends and work. You want to work it one direction. And you see your glue squirting out like that. Means you got good. Gonna let this sit overnight, and then we're gonna use some Bondo to touch up. Here's how you fix these hinges. Make them solid. Just cut some wood and make it pretty close to flush. We'll finish sanding that with the sander to get it good. Do some touch up with some Bondo, but yep, just glue them in. Let the glue dry, and then we'll move on to the next stage. Okay, we got the tops glued on yesterday, nice and solid now. Now we're just pre-filling Bondo where I filled in the
hinge cutouts, door jamb cutout, because we're going to go ahead and put the hardware back on just for looks, but we don't need this here anymore. But just pre-filling everything with Bondo. It's going to get all painted anyways, so coming together. Now I had to extend this up too. I'll show you how I did that. So it looks better with the extension of the wood going up for the barn door. Had to make an extension on this edge where the doors used to come together and latch, but just made a block, cut it, the table saw to each depth to match this, and bonded the seam so we can try to make it look like one piece when we get all done. Okay, here's the PLS I just bought. Thanks to you folks, my advertising's paying off. I paid $400 for this. They used to be made in America. Now it says assembled in China. Probably with global parts, who knows, but boys like Pacific Laser Systems. Used PLS-5s for over 15 years, and I had my PLS-3 probably for, well, a good 20 years, so PLS-5 probably 20 years as well. But gonna use this to level up that barn door now. Benchmark here. I'm going to move it and put another one here. I got my tripod, so I'm just kind of winging it. My camera phone keeps falling down. I got a dot here and a dot there. That's level. I'm going to do the same thing over there in two spots. You want to mark up the wall, fresh paint. And all four of these dots are perfectly level with the laser level anyways. So now I'll be able to measure up each point for this hardware for the barn door and get it totally level. I guarantee you it's not level. Now I framed this up before I sheetrocked it, framed it, taped it, textured it, everything. But before I put the sheetrock on, I put a 2x12 header all the way across this wall just so there's backing behind that piece of steel. Now, I just put the steel tied against the wall for now without the little spacers behind it. Just put a screw in each end. Here, might have to patch some holes with a little mud and touch it up, but anyways, now I can just use the same steel for a pilot to drill pilot holes, put the anchors in, make sure they go in good first, then pull it down and put the spacers behind it. But that's exactly 4 foot 1/2 inch from my benchmarks to the top rail here. Now I don't know, everybody's just going to be different. But that's level all the way across. And that barn door thing will just hang on top of that and slide back and forth. Found the center of the door from each end. Found the center, drew a line, and put that steel right in the center of it there. I'm just drilling these to get them started. Then when I anchor them the rest of the way, I'll rattle them in. That's far enough until I put the backing behind them. Better than drilling a pre-hole because you might get off center. It's better just to rattle the lag might bolt right in and center it up better that way. This. And if you have to, you can drill them a little deeper, but at least you got your pilot hole started. And you can touch this up with a Sharpie when you get done. Just a black Sharpie. Your rattle from your bolts. Now before you tighten these up, before you put this on, slide these door stops in first. Now if you got two doors, there'd be a right, left, center, so on so forth. You just want to make sure your set screws are on the top and your bumpers are on the doors. Now next I'm going to put this on, tighten it up before I tighten these up. I've already tightened this side up, but it's okay, I got adjustment there so I can put this together. And this house is kind of small square footage wise. They got them as French doors, but then they didn't want these doors banging into each other or swinging out, you know, into the living area, which is now the kitchen. They moved the living room down there, but they didn't want the doors banging into each other like this here. Door banging into the entry door. I put a floor stop down there so it don't hit into the glass, the doorknob. But anyways, you can see they work better. This door won't be in the way of the if it was a French door. And we just put these kind of latches on here. So, you know, they can lock it up, put another one out here. So they can basically, I know you can still get in here if you're trying to, but at least it keeps them from moving around. And if they want, they can open up this door and latch it here. We just put a latch there so they can latch at to hold it open. And we did the same thing here. We just used one instead of both, but you can latch this one to hold it there. I had to make sure I held it out far enough so it didn't hit the edge of the sheetrock there, the corner bead. But anyways, and then you can latch them shut. So it's like that. It's hard to do one-handed. But anyways, you can see they can hang a curtain up here if they want to get more privacy, which I'm sure they will. The homeowners paint. I'm not painting. Saved them some money. So I just had to have her paint where I put my hardware so she can finish painting later on. But we've been remodeling this house. This house is so out of plumb, out of square. It was built almost 100 years ago. They had the windows put in before I got here. But I sheetrocked it, textured it, and they're painting it. I did all the doors and hardware.